In December 2023, Chinese President Xi Jinping visited Vietnam. China and Vietnam are neighbors, and Vietnam shares a land border with China to the north. China aims to improve relations with its neighbor. In fact, the main objective of Xi Jinping's visit was to enhance relations with Vietnam. Are relations between the two countries at a low point? Not exactly, but China-Vietnam relations do face certain challenges. China and Vietnam share a complex relationship. Both nations have strong economic and cultural ties, with China being Vietnam's largest trading partner and Chinese companies holding significant investments in Vietnam. Despite these connections, various challenges persist in their relationship. Historically, the two nations have faced conflicts, most notably the Sino-Vietnamese War in 1979 and subsequent border clashes during the 1980s and early 1990s. Presently, China and Vietnam have territorial disputes in the South China Sea. Adding another layer to the dynamics, Vietnam is strategically upgrading its ties with the United States. This move is driven by Vietnam's considerations of its strategic interests. The US aims to increase its influence in the region by capitalizing on the pain points in Vietnam and China's relations. Vietnam can prove to be a crucial partner for the US's Indo-Pacific strategy. China recognizes this dynamic. Therefore, it is actively working to improve its relations with Vietnam. During Xi Jinping's visit, the two countries signed 37 agreements. These agreements focused on enhancing cooperation in sectors such as farming, trade, infrastructure, and technology. Additionally, agreements on security cooperation were reached. Both nations also agreed on joint maritime patrols and information sharing. China is attempting to reduce Vietnam's inclination towards the US by addressing existing issues, thereby removing obstacles in its pursuit of establishing dominance in the region. In response, the US is intensifying defense cooperation with Vietnam to counter China's growing assertiveness in the region. Vietnam is geopolitically balancing between the US and China. We will delve into this topic in the next video. In this video, our focus will be on the relations between China and Vietnam. We are aware that China is consistently trying to expand its claims in the South China Sea. You may have heard about China's infamous 9-dash line. Recently, China issued a new map featuring the 10-dash line, an extended version of the previous demarcation. Due to these actions, China has disputes with numerous countries in the South China Sea, which is not surprising. China claims ownership of approximately 90% of the South China Sea. It claims sovereignty over the Spratly Islands, Paracel Islands, Scarborough Shoal, and Macclesfield Bank. Other countries also assert their sovereignty over these islands. This leads to overlapping claims, disputes in the region, and lingering tensions. Whether it is the fishing dispute near the Spratly Islands or the contention over the Chinese oil rig near the Paracel Islands, China frequently bullies countries in the region. Behind these assertive claims, China argues that it holds historical rights over the South China Sea. It cites control over the region in ancient times. However, the international community does not recognize these claims. Countries such as Vietnam, the Philippines, Malaysia, Indonesia, and Brunei reject China's unilateral claims. In 2016, the Permanent Court of Arbitration ruled that China's claims were illegal. However, China rejected this ruling. As we discussed, there are territorial disputes between Vietnam and China over the Spratly Islands and the Paracel Islands. Additionally, there are differences between the two countries concerning exclusive economic zones. Now, what exactly is an exclusive economic zone? The area extending up to 200 nautical miles from the coastal boundary of any country is designated as the exclusive economic zone of that country. To put it in perspective, 1 nautical mile is equivalent to 1.852 kilometers. So 200 nautical miles is approximately 370.4 kilometers. Therefore, the area up to 200 nautical miles or about 370 kilometers from the coastal boundary is considered an exclusive economic zone. What are the benefits of this zone? Well, the coastal nation holds rights over all the natural resources such as oil, gas, fish, minerals, etc. within its exclusive economic zone. The coastal nation can engage in mining, exploration, and regulation of activities within this zone. The South China Sea holds significant strategic importance due to its abundant oil and gas reserves and crucial shipping lanes. As we discussed, there are differences between Vietnam and China concerning exclusive economic zones. China's 10-dash line infringes upon Vietnam's exclusive economic zone. China wants to control the vital shipping routes in the region. Given the presence of essential natural resources such as fish, oil, and gas, China has both strategic and economic interests in the area. Consequently, it is common to hear in the news that China has violated the sovereignty of other countries by sending its coast guard, fishing boats, and research vessels. Due to China's assertiveness, the situation in the South China Sea remains highly volatile. If territorial disputes escalate, there may be a military conflict in the region. This could disrupt shipping lanes, having a detrimental impact on the economy. Another point of tension between Vietnam and China is intellectual property theft. Vietnam asserts that Chinese companies engage in intellectual property infringements. The intellectual property protection systems in China are weak. That allows China to copy technology and designs from Vietnamese companies. Discussing China's intellectual property theft would require an entire video, which we will do another day. For now, let us understand that due to China's intellectual property theft, Vietnamese companies incur significant losses. The replication of products by China sold at lower prices diminishes the competitive advantage of Vietnamese companies. This leads to a decrease in Vietnam's revenue and erosion of market share. This is also a major issue between the two countries. So to address all these issues and enhance cooperation with Vietnam, Chinese President Xi Jinping visited the country. The outcome is that both nations agreed to establish hotlines to diffuse any tension in the South China Sea. They will strengthen their defense and economic ties, leaving behind the history of past conflicts. Additionally, the two countries have agreed to exchange intelligence. It was also announced that the China-Vietnam community of a shared future will be established, marking a historical milestone. Talking about rare earth minerals, both countries have agreed to cooperate in this area. According to estimates, China possesses the world's largest and Vietnam has the world's second largest rare earth mineral deposits. These critical minerals are crucial for renewable energy and electric vehicles. As we discussed, Vietnam has significant reserves of rare earth minerals. However, it lacks the technology for processing them. China can provide this technology to Vietnam. There has been talk of establishing rail links, which will benefit both countries. Emphasis was also placed on increasing cooperation in the telecom sector and digital space. China intends to build a 5G network inside Vietnam and invest in undersea infrastructure. However, the details of the deals between the two countries have not been disclosed. Only time will tell whether all this was symbolic or in reality we get to see the improving relations between China and Vietnam.